Hi, hello students, welcome back to our channel. This is Bhaskar Bora. So we are discussing 10th class maths chapter 1 real numbers. In our previous video we discussed about the fundamental theorem of arithmetic and also we see its applications. Now today in this video we are going to see the decimal expansions of rational numbers. As we all know that the rational numbers, when we express them in decimal forms, either they will be in the form of terminating decimals or they will be in the form of non-terminating repeated decimals. How do we know when do a rational number has either the form of terminating decimal or the form of non-terminating repeated decimal? We know it by doing division. So by doing division, we decided whether a rational number has the terminating decimal form or non-terminating repeated decimal form. But is there any other way to say whether a rational number has the form terminating decimal or non-terminating repeated decimal without doing actual division? So let us find out the answer for this question by considering some examples. Now let us consider a terminating decimal 0.375. So let us write this terminating decimal in the form of p by q. By writing it in the form of p by q, we get 375 by 1000. 1000 can be written as the power of 10. So let's write 375 by 10 power 3. So let us factorize the numerator and denominator to simplify this fraction. So by writing the factors of 375, we get 3 into 5 cube by, and the prime factorization of 10 power 3 is 2 power 3 into 5 power 3. 5 power 3 is the common factor for both numerator and denominator. So by cancelling it, we get 3 by 2 power 3. Let us take one more terminating decimal, that is 1.04. Let's write its p by q form. We get 104 by 100, where 100 can be written as the power of 10. So by writing it, we get 104 by 10 to the power 2. Now let's write the prime factors of numerator and denominator to simplify it. So we get 2 cube into 13 by 2 square into 5 square. In the numerator and denominator we have 2 power 2 as common factor. By cancelling numerator and denominator with 2 power 2, we get 2 into 13 by 5 power 2, that means 26 by 5 power 2. Similarly, let us consider one more terminating decimal, that is 0.0875, and let's write its p by q form. By writing it in the form of p by q, we get 875 by 10,000, and if we express 10,000 as the powers of 10, we get 875 by 10 to the power 4. And let's do the factorization of both numerator and denominator. We get 5 power 3 into 7 by 2 power 4 into 5 power 4. Now we may notice that here 5 power 3 is the common factor for the numerator and denominator. So by cancelling 5 power 3, we get 7 by 2 power 4 into 5. Let us take one more example. Consider the terminating decimal 12.5. By writing this in the form of p by q, we get 125 by 10. And by doing the prime factorization of both numerator and denominator, we get 5 cube by 2 into 5. And further simplifying, we get 5 square by 2, which is equals to 25 by 2. Now observe the denominators of all these rational forms. What do you notice? Have you observed any pattern in the denominators? You might have noticed that the denominators of these rational forms have only powers of 2 or 5 or both. This is because of powers of 10 can be the product of 2 and 5, as we discussed earlier in the fundamental theorem of arithmetic. A terminating decimal can be expressed in a rational form whose denominators is powers of 2 or 5 or both. That means if you write terminating decimal in the form of p by q, the prime factorization of q will be in the form of 2 power n, 5 power m, where n and m are some non-negative integers. So we can generalize this result. So let x be a rational number whose decimal expansion terminates, then x can be expressed in the form of p by q, where P and Q are coprimes, and the prime factorization of Q is of the form 2 power n into 5 power m, where n and m are non-negative integers. So that means, from this result, we can understand that every terminating decimal, when it is expressed in the form of P by Q, and the prime factorization of the denominator Q is of the form 2 power n into 5 power m, and where n and m are some non-negative integers. So here are some problems. Do these problems on your own. Write the following terminating decimals in the form of P by Q, where Q naught equals to 0 and P, Q are coprimes. So do these problems on your own. Let us come to our result. What is that? Let x be a rational number whose decimal expansion terminates. Then x can be written in the form of P by Q, where P and Q coprime. Then the prime factorization of Q is of the form 2 power n into 5 power m, and n here, n and m are non-negative integers. Now what about the converse of this theorem? The converse of this theorem is also true. That means, if we consider a rational number, say P by Q, where P and Q are coprimes, and the prime factorization of Q is of the form 2 power n into 5 power m, where n and m are non-negative integers, then the rational number P by Q has the form of terminating decimal expansion. Now we can say, when a rational number has the terminating decimal form by using this result, that means, terminating decimal, when its denominator is expressed as product of its primes, and that form is in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m, where n and m are some non-negative integers, then we can say the rational number P by Q has a decimal expansion which terminates. Now here we have some problems which are given under do this. Now do these problems on your own. Write the denominator of the following rational numbers in 2 power n into 5 power m form, where n and m are non-negative integers, and then write the numbers in their decimal form. Now up to now we discussed about the terminating decimal expansion of rational number. Now let us find out, when do a rational number has non-terminating repeated decimal form. Let us consider one fraction, that is 1 by 7. So by doing division, we get 1 by 7 equals to 0.142857, 142857, etc. So it is non-terminating repeated decimal. So in this, the group of digits that are 142857 are repeating again and again. Now, if we notice the denominator here, that is 7, which is a prime number. Can we write this denominator in the form of 2 power n into 5 power n? No, we cannot write 7 in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m. That means here the denominator does not has the form 2 power n into 5 power m, where n and m some non-negative integers. So from this example, we can understand that for a given rational number, say P by Q, if the prime factorization of the denominator, that is Q, is not in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m, where n and m non-negative integers, then the given rational number P by Q has the decimal expansion which is non-terminating, repeating or recurring. So here, from these two results, we can say that when do a rational number has of the form terminating and when do it has non-terminating repeating decimal form. By simply observing the prime factorization form of the denominator of the given rational number. Suppose if the denominator of the given rational number has of the form 2 power n into 5 power m, where m, n are non-negative integers, then we say the given rational number has terminating decimal expansion. And if it is not in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m, then we can say the decimal expansion of the given rational number is non-terminating recurring. So let's understand these again by doing some examples. So here we have example 5, which is given in our textbook. Let us see. Using the above theorems, without actual division, state whether decimal form of the following rational numbers are terminating or non-terminating repeating decimals. So the first problem is 16 by 125. Now we need to verify whether this has terminating decimal expansion form or non-terminating repeated decimal expansion form without doing actual division. So using the two results that we discussed just now, we can say whether a rational number has terminating decimal form or non-terminating repeated decimal form. So to verify this, we need to write the prime factors of the denominator of the given rational number. So here the denominator, that is 125. So if we factorize it, we get 5 into 5 into 5. So it can also be written as 5 power 3. So we get 16 by 5 power 3. Now if we notice the denominator here, it is in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m. So here 5 power 3 can also be written as 2 power 0 into 5 power 3, where 2 power 0 equals to 1. We know that from laws of exponents that a power 0 equals to 1, where a naught equals to 0. So here 5 power 3 can also be written as 2 power 0 into 5 power 3. Now we may notice that this form, that is 2 power 0 into 5 power 3, is in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m. So therefore, the denominator of the given rational number is of the form 2 power n into 5 power m. So we can say this rational number has terminating decimal expansion. Now let us see one more problem, that is second problem. It is given as 25 by 32. So the given rational number 25 by 32 is already in its simplest form. Now let us write the prime factors of denominator, that is 32. By writing it, we get 25 by 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. So further we can write 25 by 2 power 5. So here the 2 power 5 can be written as 2 power 5 into 1. And again further, where 1 can be written as 5 power 0. So we can write 25 by 32 as 25 by 2 power 5 into 5 power 0. Now here you can clearly understand that the form of the denominator is the form of 2 power n into 5 power m. So we can say the given rational number has the terminating decimal expansion form. Now let us see the third problem, that is given as 100 by 81. So let's write the prime factors of the denominator 81. By writing its prime factors, we get 100 by 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. And this can also be written as 3 power 4. So we get 100 by 3 power 4. And here, the prime factorization of the denominator, that is 3 power 4, is not of the form 2 power n into 5 power m. Hence, we can say the given rational number 100 by 81 has the non-terminating repeated decimal form. So the given rational number 100 by 81 has non-terminating repeated decimal form. Now the last one, that is fourth problem, it is given as 41 by 75. So here the denominator is 75. So let us do the prime factorization of this denominator 75. By writing its prime factors, we get 41 by 3 into 5 into 5. And this can also be written as 41 by 3 into 5 square. So here if you observe the denominator form, it is not in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m. Here in the denominator, along with 5, we have other prime factor, that is 3. So hence we can say the denominator is not in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m. So the given rational number, that is 41 by 75, has non-terminating repeated decimal form. So in this way, by expressing the denominator as its prime factors and verifying whether it has in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m or not in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m, we can say whether the given rational number has terminating form or non-terminating repeated decimal form. Now we have one more example, that is example 6. Let us see this example 6. Write the decimal expansion of the following rational numbers without actual division. So in this example, let us consider the first problem, that is 35 by 50. Now we need to write its decimal expansion without doing actual division. So here without doing actual division, if you want to write the decimal expansion of this rational number, so this can be done very easily by converting the denominator into the powers of 10. So let us see how to do this. Now, what is the given fraction? What is the given rational number? That is 35 by 50. Now, let us express both numerator and denominator as their product of primes. So now 35 can be written as 5 into 7 by 50. We can write its prime factors as 2 into 5 into 5. So here we have 5 as common factor for both numerator and denominator. So by cancelling 5, we get 7 by 2 into 5. By multiplying 2 and 5, we get 7 by 10, which can be written as 7 by 10 power 1. So here in the denominator, we get the power of 10, that is 10 power 1. So what is the power here? That is 1. So just in the numerator, keep the decimal point after one digit, counting from the right side. So to the left side of the 7, just keep the decimal point to get the decimal expansion of 7 by 10. So that is, by keeping decimal point to the left side of the 7, we get 0.7. So that is the decimal expansion of given rational number. And let us see one more problem, that is given as 21 by 25. So the given rational number is 21 by 25, which is in the simplest form. Now let us do the prime factorization of the denominator. Here, by writing its prime factors, we get 21 by 5 into 5, and this can also be written as 21 by 5 square. Now, what is the denominator we have? That is 5 power 2. Now this denominator should be converted into the powers of 10. The denominator 5 power 2 should be multiplied by 2 power 2, so as to get the powers of 10. So for this we need to multiply both numerator and denominator with 2 power 2. So let us multiply the numerator and the denominator with 2 power 2. We get 21 into 2 power 2 by 5 power 2 into 2 power 2. So we get 21 into 4 by 5 power 2 into 2 power 2, which can be written as 84 by 5 into 2 whole power 2. Further, we can write 84 by 10 power 2. Here, the denominator is expressed as the power of 10, that is 10 power 2. Now, what is the power we have here? That is 2. So, to write the decimal expansion of this fraction, just keep the decimal point in the numerator after 2 digits, counting from the right side. So, the 4 is the first digit and 8 is the second digit. After 8, you need to just keep the decimal point here. So, we get 0.84, that is the decimal expansion of given rational number. Now let us do one more problem, that is third problem. It is given as 7 by 8. So here 7 by 8, which is already in its simplest form. So let's express the denominator as its prime factors. So by writing its prime factors, we get 7 by 2 into 2 into 2. This can also be written as 7 by 2 power 3. Now in the denominator, we have 2 power 3. So to make this denominator as powers of 10, we need to multiply this 2 power 3 by 5 power 3. By multiplying 2 power 3 by 5 power 3, we get the power of 10. So let us multiply both numerator and denominator with 5 power 3. What we get? 7 into 5 power 3 by 2 power 3 into 5 power 3. And this can also be written as 7 into 125 by 2 into 5 whole cube, and which is equals to 875 by 10 power 3. So here the denominator is converted to the powers of 10. So what is the power of 10 here? We have, that is 3. So we need to keep the decimal point after 3 digits, counting from right side. So what is the first digit? That is 5. Second one, 7. Third one, 8. So after 8, keep decimal point. So we get 0.875. So in this way, we can write the decimal expansions of the given rational numbers without doing actual division. Now for your homework, do exercise 1.3, which is given in textbook. If you get any doubts, post your doubts in the comment section. Thank you.